Mr. Henry, I have Saturdays set aside just for you and classic blues and R&B, Papi.
This is Classic Blues and R&B.
Well, any time is a good time.
On WVON.
Hey! Like right now. Wow!
This is recording artist Sir Jonathan Burke, and you're listening to Classic Blues and R&B with Sir Henry Cheatham on AM 1690 WBON. Lock it in.
Welcome to another edition of Classic Blues and R&B here on this Kwanzaa weekend. Getting ready for the holidays, wrapping up, getting ready for the Dr. King birthday and all of that other stuff. Sir Henry Cheatham here is ready to roll out to you here and move across North America. Welcome to Classic Blues and R&B. This is where you come to get all of your real American music. When you're into the classic blues and R&B juke joint, you know you're at the right club. That's right. Here you get your real blues, a healthy shot of soul, and your much-needed dose of R&B. That's rhythm and blues. You know, blues, beer, and barbecue is a real red, white, and blue of the American way. That's what it is, folks. Once you get here at the Classic Blues and R&B, you know you found a great call letter to WBON, which has a tradition and a legacy, a heritage, you know, great music. And we're coming to you live from the middle of North America, here in the place we call the United States of America. And we hear every Saturday night from 11 p.m. to 2 a.m. And we hope that you will stick with us and enjoy this, the music of the U.S. of A. That's right, classic blues and R&B. That's it. That's what it is, folks. The music that was born, birthed, and everything else here created. They got together, had some chillings, and the children became rock and roll, rhythm and blues, and everything else. But it all started right here on this great tradition of American music, blues, classic blues, and R&B. Sir Henry Cheatham here, along with my man, Mr. What the hell is his name? He was gone last week. Oh, your name is Gerald Britz. Brother Gerald Britz Jr. is on the other side of the glass. Glad to have you back. I hope you enjoyed your time off, you know, away from me. Now, that didn't worry. You didn't have me to worry with that during that period. Say farewell to my man, Brother Linnell, as he leaves and goes to Sunday morning, early Sunday morning. Enjoyed being with him. Occasionally see his wife, Pam, and his other partner that was here. I thought we had a good thing. Well, what do you think about our weekend crew? I thought we had a pretty good weekend crew. Celine kicked it off. Linnell came in, and damn, I came in and hit the home run to wrap it up.
It was a very good crew.
Yeah.
I'm the backbone of the whole thing, so.
All right. But anyway, change is constant, as they say. You know, tomorrow is a mystery. As we go down that road, you know, you never know. We know what we did today. We know what we did yesterday, you know. But tomorrow, we really don't know. But we hope that we get and do what we set out to do. We hope that most of it will turn out right, you know. Remember, folks, ignorance is the most costly crop that any community can produce. And in this year of 2018 coming up, that quote from Mr. Williams will be 100 years old. 100, a century years old. It has a standing, and it's still here. Remember, because there's a whole bunch of it. You know, people out talking a lot of smack, and I was telling the guy today, he works for Comcast. You know, they talk about net neutrality, and I said most folks don't even know what that means or when it came about. Bill Clinton, all those guys started that stuff. I said, you know, they have no idea what it's about. I said, what they need to worry about, you know, you had, you know, two numbers on your, you know, with the UHF, you had two numbers on your television dial, and when you got cable, you know, they went 1, 2, then they got three numbers on you. You need to wonder what the hell is that fourth number you got on your cable box now. That's what you need to worry about, because most of you will be affected by that. That net neutrality will not slow down anything. It's not going to hurt at all. But then what they're simply doing is saying, hey, take it to Congress and let Congress work it out. Let Congress make a law. It's either they don't want it to be. It's either telephone or it's not, you know, part of the FCC Act. And so that's what they're doing with it, folks. So understand your government. Read a little bit about it. You might learn something from it. You need read a little bit for yourself. Don't let nobody else be telling you everything, you know. You know, there's always somebody who has a special interest out there. They had a special interest to get rid of the Savage, and they did. And they brought in, Mel Reynolds. Well, and then after Mel Reynolds, they said, well, now we got him. And then they threw him out, and they brought in Jesse Jr. And they created the situation for Jesse Jr. and all his stuff. And now they got the young lady out there, so Robin Kelly. We'll find out, you know, what Bloomberg and the guys want her to do. But anyway, it's up to us, folks. Every 2 years, we got a chance to get rid of somebody. Every 2 years, we can change this government. And I think people need to understand that. Start looking every 2 years, you know. On the 18th, you know, you got some. And somebody else goes, you know, you got one-third of the senators, they get out of town. It's just a whole lot of things. Once you learn what your government is all about, you realize the power that you have. The president's not important. It's your congressmen, your senators from the U.S.
I think things are pretty bad, Sir Henry.
Well, I'm just saying, though, people.
Charles Stroger, you know, has, you know, come out the woodworks to run again. I mean, come on now.
Yeah, Todd is a disappointment. I thought he was serious, but he's a disappointment. And when I see Todd up with that alderman over there, Brookings, I said, it's a joke. You know, I mean, here it is, Todd Stroger, Ken Duncans. I don't care how y'all feel about him. I'm telling you how I feel about him and what we need to do. All of these guys need to be sitting at the feet of Emile Jones and Roland Burris and these guys, man. And, you know, really trying to make things happen, you know. Todd is not a dummy. You know, he got legislative powers on both state and local government, you know, in the city, you know, as well as the county. And it's just a shame that the young Negroes cannot, you know, see themselves getting together, creating a political system that works, you know, like the Irish community does, the Jewish community does, and the Spanish speakers seem to be doing, you know, even though they're being manipulated like the brothers and sisters are in the black community. But, you know, hey, this is what's going on. We need to open up your eyes, folks, to find out what's going on. All right, son, I think we're about ready to get into the show here. I told Neil I was going to send this first song out to him because I think this is what life is all about. You know, we do get to these points in life where, you know, we come to the end of the road or circle or whatever it may be. But Charles Wright and the boys did it. Facebook, WVON, want you to get social with us there by going to facebook.com/WVON1690. On Twitter at WVON1690. And Instagram at WVON1690. That's 1690. And we in HD, soon to be in 4K HD. Oh, boy. Can you imagine, man? 4K HD, man. Hey, I'm gonna look better. I'm gonna look real good, man. You guys, you know, y'all be looking. Look at that.
You gonna look good?
Oh yeah, I look good anyway. You know, yeah, I look good and standing there.
No, I don't judge guys, so I don't know.
I ain't worried about that. I know you.
I judge the ladies. That's why I say. Let me see a lady like that.
That's why I say I'm gonna be looking good, man. You know, hey, you're gonna be looking good in 4K HD, 4K. Damn, I'm telling you, folks, change is, like I say, it's constant. You know, you imagine you just went to HD, you know, digital, First you went to HD, then you got digital. We did that, and now all of a sudden you got these 4Ks. Which, yes, gives you a little bit better picture, as they say, but damn. You know, anyway, we're going to get into the show here. We chit-chat more as we go across the way here. This is going out for my man, Linnell Harris, and his wife, Miss Pam. I just say good luck to him on Sunday morning, 7 to 9. Good slot. And he will do well. He did well here. We know we all enjoyed each other. We used to have some great walkthroughs. I always like to hit the Saleem, bam, with something, and they all walks in, you know, there we go, we got something, you know. So it was all good, folks. I enjoyed it. So it's not a death or nothing like that. Hell, it's just speaking of death, understand, I got the Don Palmer, great journalist that was in this town. He worked at WBMX. And a couple other stations around. He also GCI, and he worked here at VON too, I think. But I understand that he has passed. He was a very good radio journalist, Donald Palmer. Our condolences and prayers goes out to his family. All right, here we go, folks. You're listening to Classic Blues and R&B, the great Charles Wright, and the Watch 133 Rhythm Man. You tell me if you can find anything better and more appropriate than what this young man is talking about. You listen to Classic Blues and R&B on WVON, 1690 AM.
been loving you too long. You don't always know when love begins. I don't wanna know when this one ends. I keep telling myself, gotta be strong. I don't wanna hear you saying so long. Let me go on pretending you still love me too. I don't want this to be ending. You know I'm in love with you. You don't always know when love begins. I don't wanna know when this one ends. I keep telling myself, gotta be strong. I don't wanna hear you saying so long.
This is Classic Blues and R&B, music with a feeling.
Willing to pay. You were wrong. You must.
All right, there you heard my man Don Johnson said, it ain't easy being blue. Denise LaSalle, caught in your mess again. caught in your mess, you said, but I just added that again to it. Eddie Cotton, catch I wanted, something he really wanted, a chick. Now, he didn't want to catch the stuff that Denise was talking about. Wee Willa Walker and Anthony Paul, Soul Orchestra. I don't wanna know something you just don't know. That's from his CD After a While, with little Willie Walker. Wee Willie Walker, his name is. Charles Wright, Watch What on Third Street Rhythm Band, The Road Without End. That went out for my man Linnell Harris there. That we will always be together. You know, we're gonna still enjoy the company of him. Yeah. And, of course, Ray Charles opened the program up for us tonight. All here on Classic Blues and R&B, folks. So how are you down there, Miss Florence? How are you doing down there in Memphis, Tennessee? I hope you're keeping warm. You know, y'all been a little chilly down there. You know, the old Magnolia boy been up here. A little chilly, but, hell, y'all been chilly, too, you know. So, so welcome to the club. Welcome to the club. You know, hey, welcome to the club, man. You know, it's a good place to be. It's a little chilly out here. I think around zero out here. I don't know what the hell it is, but hey, beautiful sunshine. You know, sunshine always makes me feel good. I don't care where I am. I got that sunshine. It's always a good thing. You know, one thing I've been wondering about, and since it has happened here in the last month almost, why is the media, American media, silent about the U.S. government, which is a crock of mess in my book, having the Russian television to register as a foreign agency? That, folks, stinks. If you ever take a look at Russian television, you will know that you're getting real, real news from an international perspective. Nothing biased about it. It's Russian news. It's better than Fox. It's better than CNN, you know, and MSNBC. It's better than those stations. You know, those stations are really slanting it and pushing it. Russia got some fine international reporter. They used to have some colored reporters on there. I don't know what the hell happened to them, you know. Yeah, they were there for a while, you know, doing a good job, too. I see that the Golden Globe is coming up, and they need something about they're going to wear black for in honor of the women who have been supposedly attacked by these men. I'm going to let y'all know something, lady. There was a young lady by the name of Joanne Little. And Joanne was, she'll be about 60-something today. She's a young black lady. She went on trial in 1974 for the murder of a white prison guard down in Washington, North Carolina. Anyway, Joanne Little was a lady who was being raped by this prison guard, and she did what you ladies should have done. You know, she stabbed the bastard and killed him. And she was later found, she was acquitted of a crime, you know, because when they found this bastard, he had his pants off and all the rest of stuff, a whole lot of other detail, you know. But she dealt with him, and she dealt with him. His name was Clarence Allgood. He was 62, and she was a much younger woman. And he was naked from the waist down when they found him. She stabbed him with an ice pick. Don't ask me where else she got it from. Stabbed him in the temple, in the heart area with an ice pick. Semen was discovered on his leg. Little was missing. She turned herself in later on, but because she escaped, she left the jail at that point. It said that she killed Allgood while defending herself against sexual assault. Folks, this was back in the 70s, so you ladies who come lately talking all that noise, most of you know, you haven't even thought about Joanne and what she did and how she did it. You know, I think it's something you ought to look at. You know, speaking of the black community early, the black community need to take a look at itself and to see how it can achieve its independence that we once had. Folks, we used to be an independent folk. Don't give me that crap because of segregation. It had nothing to do with that. We had folks with some sense. They had sense. They decided, hey, this is what I want to do. How you doing, my man? Groovy Grant down there in Kansas City. Hey, how you doing, Brother Groovy? It's always good to have you on board, man. Miss Martha, how you doing down there in Texas? And we'll say hi to Officer Jones. I checked him out this week. And he's hanging in there. Good positive attitude, you know. His wife, Michelle, you know. I'm going to caretaker, folks, to tell you. It's a good job, you know, and what I mean by it's a good job, it is good to have someone that you get tired, but, you know, you do it anyway. You do what you need to do or have to do, so it's a good thing, you know. And that's him, just like Daryl does for his father, Daryl Spann. He does a good job of taking care of his own man. It's all good stuff, you know. But anyway, the Negro community need to do something about, I understand that they go out and they vote for Doug Jones, whatever the hell his name is. Nobody heard of four little girls on that other side of the street, up north anyway, New York and all that crap. They go down there. And all of a sudden, they want to regurgitate their names out. But as I said before on this show, you get them, get their names every year. And constantly, I think about them, you know. Some young man got the hell beat out of him down in Alabama there, just Troy, Alabama, they said it was, you know. So, folks, you got to make choices that are good for you. You had to use your power. You can't be just a set dressing like it was for Claypool, you know, when you had all these Negroes standing around, you know, Reverend Brazier and all the rest of them. They're supporting this guy, Rahm Emanuel. I have nothing for or against him, you know. And as I said before, thank God for the folks of the suburb, for Chicago. You know, they allowed all these crazy things to be done under that dummy. Yeah, that's another reason they got that's another reason they got rid of a bad guy. Gus was that Dom Dom Daly, you know. Hey, you know, I always try to make something out of nothing, you know. All right, let's get back to some more music. Yeah, I see Clive Bundy. I got to talk about him last week. Clive Bundy was a mistrial was declared in him. He was out there in Nevada. He was a rancher out there. And we had a group, folks, at one time called the Deacons for Defense. Don't let nobody tell you that the National Rifle Association is bad for colored folks, because, hey, you can become a member, too. There's nothing to keep you from becoming a member of the National Rifle Association. And you are granted all the rights anybody else is granted, you know. Carry your rifle, too. Down south, you people be surprised, maybe, maybe not. Hey, when the white folks had their rifle in the truck, we had some black folks riding around with the rifles in their trucks, too. Because we do a lot of hunting down there, you know. It was matter of looking for a meal, not trying to hurt nobody. But yeah, the brothers, you know, my dad and them, they had their shotgun. Everybody had a gun down there, a shotgun. And it wasn't for to go out and stick somebody up like these dummies are doing, you know. But it was for a purpose, you know, protection. Back to some more music here on Classic Blues and R&B here. You're listening to Classic Blues and R&B here on WVON 1690 AM. That's what I call music, folks. That's what I call music. That was a young boy. He was a little young kid, Frankie Lyman. You know, hell, I don't. He may have been 21. Yeah, I don't know. But he was with Frankie Lyman and the Teenagers, great group out of New York City. Many of you have seen probably the movie, and a movie is not always accurate, especially when it's a movie. Documentary may be a little closer, but a movie, somebody told me that when they made What Love Got to Do With It, and this is from a reliable source. Said Tina said, that's not the way Ike was. And the producers said, you want this movie made, don't you? And hey, no, that's how it turned out to be. Because I'm going to tell you, folks, on the other side of the street, people want to make that every blues singer is an alcoholic. Not true. I don't even know if BB did any drinking. That every blues singer is on drugs. Not true. I knew some guys who were not on that. And they lay up there and died for other reasons, but none of that, you know. All right, we'll be back following the news here on New Year's Eve on Classic Blues and R&B on WVON 1690 AM.
Talk of Chicago and the voice of the nation. 1690 WVON, Berwyn, Chicago.
All right, folks, as we get into the final hour here of Classic Blues and R&B for this year. Damn, that is true, isn't it? Yeah, today is the 31st. For this year, for 2017. Hope to be back up in here on the 18th, you know, 2018. Sir Henry Cheatham, along with Gerald Brister Jr. on the other side of the wall over there. And we try to do it each and every Saturday night. We try to make sure that you enjoy this great American music here. The music of North America, the music of the United States of America, the USFA. You would do it, you know, we prepare for it. Put it together for you, and hopefully you enjoy it. And if you don't, then let us know, and I guarantee you, we'll play something you like, something you enjoy, patting your feet to, even a young chump like my man on the other side over there. He'll find something you like to pat his feet to, you know. Hell, I've been watching it. You know, they come up in here, these young guys. The next thing you know, I'm not about that stuff. Yeah, the next thing you know, they start patting their feet to it. You know? Uh-huh. I said, we're going to church today. Then I take up a collection. They all give me a little bit of money, you know, a little collection, you know, for the learning process. They don't pay me what tuition is worth, but hell, they give, you know. I was just lying. They don't even do that, you know. They just take, you know, they like to soak it up and run over to the other side of the street and say that's where they got it from. But it will be streaming live at WVON.com and iHeartRadio. And remember, folks, ignorance is the most costly crop that any community can produce. And that's over 100 years ago by Mr. Edward J. Williams out of Snow Hill, Snow Hill, Alabama. Yes, Snow Hill, Alabama. And he was a graduate of Tuskegee Institute down in Tuskegee, Alabama. You know, Booker T. Washington and George Washington Carver. Yes, yep, that's it. You know, that great university still exists too, folks. Great university. Can't beat it. I was looking for some how to grow potatoes up in this part of the country. And I guarantee you can go there and you'll find what Dr. Carver, which is what the damn agriculture department in this country should be named. George Washington Carver Agricultural Department, rather than J. Edgar Hoover and some of them bastards, you know, who didn't do a damn thing to contributed nothing, you know, to the country or to the world of value, you know, but a bunch of racist, bigoted garbage, you know. WVON wants you to get social by going to Facebook.com/ WVON1690, Twitter, WVON1690, and on Instagram at WVON1690. Don't forget to come over and join me on Sunday or any other time over at the Morphy Point Marine Association. Come on out and join us. And support us. You know, we got the Sam Cochran, the brother of the ghetto, coming over there on the 19th. And, you know, come on out and support us. Yeah, it's a nice place. You know, you come in, ladies, you can be assured that you're going to be respected. So don't sweat that, you know. Even though it says the Marine, you know, hell, us Army guys go in there and give it a little class. Yeah, we go in and give it a little class, you know. So, you know, the ladies know that. I tell you, that old Marine uniform, they used to be so outstanding. But it is still a beautiful uniform. But, hell, we got a good one now for the Army, you know. Shucks, we got a very good one, you know. Life is good. I think the old tax bill may help a lot of us poor folks. I don't mean me, hell, you know, but I'm talking about, you know. Because what they did, they made it possible for everybody to be a corporation. Including you, Gerald. You are a corporation already, right? You're working on your first 1,000, right?
Right now, I'm an independent contractor right now.
Right, so yeah, that's what this doggone tax bill seems like it's working on, man. You know, you're independent contract, contractor, hell, you can do a few things with it, you know. I tell you what I want you to do for me, girl. I'm going to chat while you do this. Find me a Chick Willis, stoop down, baby. Chick, C-H-I-C-K, W-I-L-L-I-S. So look for her now on YouTube. Yeah, I tell you what you could do, though. I tell you, meanwhile, give me that Curtis Elgato and my man Wagner there. Okay? So you can put that CD in there. And, by the time you find it, it's over there on the new CD. The Curtis Elgato CD. You see it? I think it's cut 3. Put that one in there for me. And I'll shut my mouth. And, I'll shut my mouth while you do your thing. But meanwhile, while you do that, as a man from Florida, a Florida man now living in Bali, is fighting for his life after he fell from a roof while chasing a monkey that had stolen his favorite Pittsburgh Steelers cap. The Northwest West Florida Daily News reported that Jeff Swede, S-W-E-D-E, Sweden, fell 33 feet. And as he did that, he said the villagers took him to a local hospital where he was diagnosed with severe damage to his spinal cord. He currently is paralyzed from the chest down, chasing that doggone cap of his, you know. Hey, I know how it is, you know. Sometimes you got some. My son, I had a Blackhawk cap, a real Blackhawk cap, and I give him a rough time about it. I said, "You won't let me forget that, Daddy." Well, I said, "No." He wore my Blackhawk cap to school, with all of these little Blackhawk fans up here in St. Cajetan, you know. And I believe one of them stole it and took my cap. He had no business wearing it, no way. But the next thing I know, I don't have my Blackhawk cap. And I mean, that was a real, you know, cap, you know, not like this crap they got today they make in China. You're listening to the Classic Blues and R&B on WVON 1690 AM.
Said, I'll give you lessons if you get it down tight. Well, one night only for you. But don't you tell nobody about a little rendezvous. Yeah. Daughter needs
running short. But when I asked for my money, she didn't have no more. Well, one night only, that's fair. And when the sun came up, I had boogied on out of there. Ride, ride, ride. You know the big bad wolf said a Red Riding Hood, I'll give you some riding, honey, that will do you some good. Well, there's one night only for you. And then it's up at Granny's house, yeah, I know she needs some riding too. You know, she took the vow, but when she saw the young deacon, she broke it anyhow. Well, there's one night only, they say. But when the church bell rang, it was ringing for the wedding day.
two-step, moving round and round, take it on down, hold me close, shake it to the one that you love the most. Take it to the end, take it to the end, yeah. Take me in your arms, kiss me and caress me, you know I like it like that, I like it like that.
To the dynamic blues and soul sounds of Sir Henry Cheatham on WVON 1690 AM.
Hi, this is Shamika Copeland, and you're listening to Classic Blues and R&B with Sir Henry Cheatham on 1690 WVON AM Chicago.
I'll do anything that you want me to do. And there ain't nothing, baby, I wouldn't do for you. TV, don't got a phone, don't got a roommate, I live all alone. Don't need a door, I don't need locks, living my life in a cardboard box. Cardboard box. Cardboard box. Cardboard box.
Life was so sweet. Didn't always live out here on the street. You should have seen me flying so high. Now I'm just trying my best to get by in this box. A cardboard box.
In a cardboard box. A mansion of stone. Life is rough, it only gets worse. We all end up in a box. I just got mine first. Cardboard box. All I got is my cardboard box. Forget about a pillow. Cardboard box.
In this cardboard box.
Blues come calling, no it never knocks. Living my life in a cardboard box.
Hi, this is Lerone Powers, and you're listening to Sir Henry on Classic Blues and R&B on AM 1690 WVOE.
This is classic blues and R&B music with a feeling.
So you think you deserve to come back? So you say you're sorry, and I'm supposed to let you come back?
No, I ain't gonna do it.
No,
no, I ain't gonna do it.
Well, I'm glad you're sorry, but it ain't meant to happen like that.
'Cause I don't want you.
Cause when you left me, didn't think I could go on. I'm telling you.
Hey, Chicago, this is Ernie Izzy of the Izzy Brothers, and you're listening to Sir Henry on Classic Blues.
All right, folks, wrapping up again, end of the year for us, and we want to thank you all for listening wherever you may be. Hope you continue to support us here on Classic Blues and R&B. Like our Facebook page at Classic Blues and R&B. Subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/HenryCB6175. Follow us on Twitter at WVONHenry. Just heard my man Howlin' Wolf, the great Wolf, the boy, my man Howlin' Wolf, Red Rooster. And you also heard Charnette Hyder in that segment, I Got a Lover. You heard Lerone Powers, I need Your Sugar. Thank God that sugar tax didn't make it, boy. I'm so glad, ever. You know, my wife is going along with it. I ain't thinking about it. I guess anything I like, she's going to go against it anyway. Chick Willis. Stoop Down, Baby. Booker Brown, Saturday Night at the Primetime Party. Shamika Copeland, Cardboard Box. Sailor Soul, I Like It Like That. James Grove, What Happened to Soul Music. All here on Classic Blues, folks. And remember, as I said, as in parting, as I do in greeting you, you know, Muslims say, As-salamu alaykum. So, you know, ignorance is the most costly crop that any community can produce. And, America at this point has produced quite a bit. And I'm not talking about the president, you know. So until next week, enjoy your Kwanzaa, your New Year and all. Until then, adios.
The Talk of Chicago.